Coach, just start off with the opening statement about tonight's game.
Well, you know, first of all, we're thankful for the win. You know, always it's a blessing to come out, being so many days off, and get you guys back into the gym, get to the floor, compete and get on a high level. You know, the SIC conference, this thing is wide open. Anybody can come out and win, it just comes down to who's going to come out and play hard, play with their mistakes. And tonight, we're just blessed to come out with a victory.
Coach, just kind of talk about your hot start. Is that something that, you know, maybe you were preaching to your guys heading into tournament week, that just to come out hard and come out strong? That's kind of really what pushed you guys throughout the game, is that big
lead? Absolutely. We need to come out with a big hot start, make some plays early, and get them down quick that we have a chance. And it's also a momentum builder. You know, anytime you've been off, like I said, so long, you want to come out to a quick start, not come out flat. To me, though, the first 2 minutes, we were still kind of shaky. Mm-hmm. Once the guys got their jitters out and relaxed, we are going to have a little fun.
Terrence, kind of talk about your performance tonight. Coach said he wanted you guys to have fun. 18 points, 5 rebounds, 3 assists, a pair of steals. Just talk about your performance.
It was just mental preparation. You know, we had a hard week of practice before us. And, you know, we just got a goal we want to achieve. So it's sort of easy getting out there and playing. We got to line up a goal.
Coach, kind of just talk about Terrence a little bit. He's been one of your leaders all season. Maybe talk about him and some other people that kind of stepped up for you tonight. You had 4 players in double figures. Talk about their performances as well.
Well, you know, Terrence didn't do no more than what we expect of him. You know, he's a leader. He's a veteran. He was here last year. You know what it takes. You know, he still has the bitter taste in his mouth. So do I, the rest of the guys who came up short last year. So he understands what we're asking and what we're looking for. And, you know, we expect him to lead and coach the younger guys, more so than myself. You know, the times in the locker room, times at the back at the hotel, on the bus. When you depend on a person like Terrence, and also Tevin Roberts, you know, guys who've been there through that fight and understand what it means. You know, I got to take my hat off tonight to a kid that's been struggling plantar fasciitis all year, and that's Brandon Zachary. That kid stepped up for me tonight big time. Like, I wasn't expecting to see what he done tonight, and so I want him to know I love him, and I'm so proud of this, to see him get back on the court and be effective, you know, playing with his confidence as high as it is.
Coach, talk to us a little bit about some of your runs that you guys did. Well, you went a couple of minutes where you guys continually scored and they could not come back. What do you think, what did you guys do to make sure that you guys attacked, or the intensity on the attack?
Well, it was just a matter of me challenging the guys in timeouts. They got, let's go win the next 2 minutes. Let's get 3 stops in a row. Let's get 5 stops in a row. And anytime you can take the stops in a row and then maybe just score another end, whether it's field goals or free throws, that's part of your run. And that's all the game is. It's just a matter of big plays, stops, and who can execute.
In the first half, you guys shot for 87% from the line, from the free throw line. What do you think gave your team that confidence to be able to do that tonight?
Oh, it's just a matter of paying attention to detail and getting in the gym and working hard and practice, really challenging themselves on the free throw line. And I couldn't be more proud of them. I think Brandon Zachary, he was 2 for 2 and 7 for 9 from the field. Like I said, he played really, really well off the bench. Well, he actually started for us tonight, but. You know, for a guy who hasn't played probably 10 games all year and come in tonight and do what he did, and it was just a big lift and make the job easy for Bridgman and Robinson and Cooper and all those guys, because we got a different spot.
How does it feel taking the victory on the first game of the tournament? You've been here last year, you know exactly what it takes. How does it feel tonight to have this victory?
It's definitely a monkey off your back. You know, the first game is the biggest game to me. You know, a lot of people think it's the semifinals or the championship, but I always felt like if you can get the first one over with, get your guys relaxed, and then go back and watch some film and study what happened in that first ball game. Everyone jitters, leave, and as you saw tonight, it was really tight the first 2-3 minutes. But after that, everybody relaxed and had fun. So you got to credit that to getting that game one over with.
So the next game is going to be on Thursday night at 7:45 p.m. against either Central State or Morehouse. You've played both of those teams this year. How do you guys feel about the next game?
Well, for us, it's just a matter of the next team up. We're not going to have no preference on who it is we're going to face. You know, in my eyes, and I'm sure in my players' eyes, and when I get through talking to them, we own both teams. So it doesn't matter. You know, Central State, we're on our senior night, and then Morehouse stopped a win streak we had early in January. So we're going to sit back tonight and watch a great ball game. And best of luck to whoever wins, but the Dragons will be waiting for them.
Coach, again, a phenomenal job tonight where you ran. You had the lead throughout the entire game. Talk to us a little bit about the preparation that went into game 1 of the conference.
a lot of hard work and practice the week before. That's all it was. And then I can't take no credit. It's all about the young men that we're coaching, Coach Young and I are coaching. Those guys just paid attention to detail, and they came in mentally focused every day. You know, we had a rough week of preparation. Then we had midterms to have to deal with. So those guys had to go out on their plates. You know, champions step up and accept any challenges thrown their way, and that's what they did for me tonight.
Terrence, final question. Moving on to the next game, you being a leader on this team, what do you go back to tell your team to get them prepared to advance in the next round of this tournament?
This is a stepping stone. We just got to move forward from this. We can't save it a moment at all. We got to, you know, build from it and just be prepared for the next game. Like Coach said, we don't care who it is that we're playing. We just going to get out there and win.
All right. Well, thank you so much, guys. Congratulations on the win.